Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a parametric facade design in Revit. As you can see on my screen there, I am in website cycle.com. It's a parametric design for facade design. It's an amazing facade design. When you scroll down, you can see the architectural information. And there is the gold fabricate on their factory. Once you done for design and your client got approval, you can straight away ask them for quote and give exact cost to your client. And of course, here is their project that they applying before. You can check it out for the website. I will put link in the description. And they got their download for plugin for Revit also. Once you select here, they will transfer you to another package. It's a download in free Revit. As you can, it's a bin object. Here is we got many types of that you can download and ask them for fabrication, then give you a exact quote for that. Okay, anyway, today I'm not going to show you how to download and how to use that. I'm going to show you how to create that by using our existing family file with our masking inside to create that. Okay, so now let's speak into our project together. Before I getting started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel and you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for notification because you won't miss my future tutorial. Let's stick around together and quick to jump into our project. Okay, so now I am in Revit architecture interface. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to create family type first before we place our masking file. Go to new and go to family as a regular English for metric. I'm going to use for, we can use two types of that. One, you can use for metric generic model adaptive. Secondly, you can using for pattern based. I prefer for using for pattern based here. Okay, so now read on my family interface. I would like to resize for scale our panel first. I will make for horizontal deep 1.5 meter. And here I will make it for 3 meter. Hit apply. Okay, let me switch back to their website first. Okay, as you can see, they got 5 tiles to get that. We assume that for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we got 5 tiles there. We will create our pattern based for pie tile about that. If you want to know how to create that and exact size with a structure to do that, follow along together. Don't skip that. So I will speak back first. I'm going to reference, then plus point. We'll start plus point here every corner there. And of course, I will press that again because I want to move, but will be got some error message. I don't care about that. I will just go ahead. Hit escape a couple of times. Hit a tab key on my keyboard until I got only my point here. Hit a tab key first. Okay, sorry. Like this, then hit a tab key again, select another. We hold control key here. We for move command, I can start move from here. And make move it for 1 meter and CO for copy. I will copy that and straight away give it for 1.9 meter. Hit escape a couple of times first. Then I can select another tool guide there. I will give a parametric for offset here. Later on, you will know the reason why I create two parameter there because our shape is something like this, not flat one. Later on, you will know the reason. Quick name, give it for offset and hit OK. Then go to our family type. I will offset it for 600 millimeter. Then hit apply. Then hit OK again. Okay, so now it's time to assign for parametric for our top point there. Once you assign that, you could not directly for dimension that. You need to set a work plan first because if you directly, it will be wrong position. I can go to set there. Hit a tab key until I got the horizontal like this. Then it's time to place our dimension. DI on my keyboard for dimension shortcut key. Hit escape a couple times. It's time to create our parametric. create new parametric. I will make it for offset. Okay, offset we got already, sorry about that. I will make it for flexible control point. Yep. Then rescale that for 1/50. Select here and assign the same parametric. Then I'm going to, let me take a look first. Okay, so now it's time to create our shape. Go to reference here, select line, and make sure you turn on for 3D snapping. Let me see first, it's turned on for 3D snapping. Now it's time to draw that. I will start draw here. I hope you got see it clearly. Here is a square one. Hit escape, and there again. It's a triangle shape. Hit escape. Then the top one is a rectangle. Hit escape a couple of times. Okay, perfect. It's time to create our structure, because one, we need to create our structure first. Only we create our panel there. How to create that? You can go to your reference there, then press point again, and I will press here. Hit escape a couple of times. Set a plan. I will set for vertical one. Vertical. Then go to circle here. I will simply make it for, let's say we make it for 30. Hit escape a couple of times. You need to copy that for multiply, because you cannot directly to create a shape. Let me show you first. If I directly to create, select all of them like this and create a form, as you can see here will be extend the structure, where we got many structure will be overlap and will be so messed up. So I don't want to mess up with that. I will control Z a few second. I will select all like this, then CO for copy. I will copy that a multiple, then make sure you turn on for multiple there. It's time to copy that. Hit escape a couple times. Let me count first. 3. Okay, 9 is perfect. Now it's time to repaint all of them to a new reference line. I can select here. Make sure you select all your points. Yeah, it's a middle point. Then you can pick a new host. Pick a new host. Then I can pick here. Then I'm going to select here again. Sorry, hit escape first. I know it will be take some time, but this is the correct way you can do it properly. Trust me. If you don't trust me, you can try out by themselves actually. Yeah, I just kidding. Okay, we almost reached our goal there. Okay. Okay, where L? Okay, this last guy there. Hit escape a couple of times. Okay, so now we got our point with our set point here. It's perfect. It's time to create our structure. I can select my circle here. Select our reference plane. Simply create form. As you can see, it's perfectly. Now it's time to repeat our process here. I will faster do that. Okay, the last two guy there. I just remind you, select your circle, not select your point on middle there. Okay, perfect. Now we got our structure there. I can select all here like this, then filter. I will need to assign a new material for parametric curtain panel. Apply, then hit OK. Then we'll be show up for material. A material for vimeo, we make it for structure for name. It's okay. Then I'm going to hide that. Hide element. Okay, so now it's time to create our panel. Select our three guide for triangle shape here. Create form. Prefer for a flat one. And for rectangle there. Okay. Okay, the last one is our glass panel. The top here is a glass panel, actually. Boom, you done our glass panel. Now it's time to assign for parameter material source, like all, filter, check none, curtain panel, apply, okay. Now I want to unselect for the top one first. Before our top one is different material, hold a shift key on my keyboard for unselected, then create a new material there. Assign a new parameter, we make it for aluminium. Okay, then I will select my top one only, create a new material here, glass C. Okay, perfect. HR for reverberate element. Now it's time to assign a material first before we create our tie there. I will show you how to create tie. Now I show you to create our material first. Structure, new material. Quick name, give it for ACM. ACM means aluminium composite material for alloy bond. Appearance library, metal. I prefer for use gold. Okay, it's gold. Apply, then hit OK. Glassy there, I will create a new glassy. And I prefer for the blue color also, blue glassy. Okay, where is it? Okay, perfect. Let me turn on for realistic first. It's perfect, as you can see. When I zoom in. Okay, the reason here, because I haven't applied that yet, I need to apply that. That's why I saw only gold color, only our top, our structure. Again, I can copy that and Control V, apply. Okay, perfect. As you can see, it's zoom in closely. It's quite cool for this material. Okay, now it's time to create tie. As you know, I got create the parametric there for control my dimension. Now you know the reason I create that family tie there. I think make easier for you to saw that like this. It is your, is it? I don't know. Okay, new tie there. Taiwan. For Taiwan, I will make it for 2 meter. Let's apply. Let's see here. Okay, as you can see, create a new tie there, tie 2, and I will make it for 1.5 meter. Apply, as you can see. Then I create a new tie there, tie 3. I will make it for 800. Perfect. Tie 4, I simply make it for 400. And the last tie there is tie 5. You could not give this one for 0, it will be got error message because here we got assigned a parametric. I will make it small closely, I just make it for 10. Then apply. Okay, perfect. Let's testing our parametric. Okay, as you can see. Everything is running properly. It's time to load into our project. Now it's time to load that. I can simply load into project and make sure you sell that, because before that I got sell already or another project. So I simply load into. Now it's time to create our masking and size. I can go to mask, implant mask, mask one. I prefer use for polygon size, make it for 6 size. And simply drag here, make it for, I think make it around 30 meter is enough. Hit escape a couple of time, go to our 3D and I can select all my polygon sign there, create form, solid form, and okay, 30 meter is enough. Hit escape a couple of time. Now it's time to create our divide, our surface. I can divide one only because just for example, and divide surface. Change our parametric there for fixed distance, and change our wheel grill there as well. Make it for 1.5 meter as our same as our pattern there. It's apply. It's perfect. HI on my keyboard for height element. Now it's time to press that. Before I press that, I need to open our node first. Just select here, then open node there. Open node. Okay. It's time to press that. CM on my keyboard for shortcut key. Now it's time to press that. I will simply press start from here. 1 and 2, 3, 4. Perfect. Continue. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The last guy there is the final guy. Actually, the final guy is a gentleman. Yeah, I just kidding. Okay, come on, gentleman. Yeah. Let me delete first. See him again. Okay, perfect. Now just on a type one only, how could you apply that? If you watch my previous tutorial, you will know how to apply that. Now I will show you again. I can start here, but I won't make it for change from type one, type two, type three, type four, type five. I will make it random, make it more interesting a bit. I will change it to type five, and this guy will change it to type three, and this guy will change it to type four. And here I will change it to type 2. It apply. Okay, perfect. Now we got our random facade. It turned on for realistic. You will saw that. It's quite cool, as you can see. We got our structure is running properly until our here. It's joining also properly, as you can see. Let me zoom for you first. Here, as you can see. It's quite cool. Now it's time to arrange that. I will select all 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then straight away repeat that. We'll be repeating, as you can see, it's quite cool and quite fast. Okay, we got our structure, we got our glass panel. When you apply into your project, it's quite interesting for that. And I can say this one is advanced level. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and from start to finish, make sure you thumbs up for this tutorial if you enjoyed that, and hit subscribe button below if you haven't subscribed yet, because your like and your subscriber is motivate me to bring more professional content about Revit. Thank you guys for joining me, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.